as a continuum of aromaticity. Today we have to discuss about the aromaticity of anilines. What are anilines? They are conjugated monocyclic hydrocarbon or monocyclic hydrocarbon with alternate single and double bond. Example, aniline for or cyclobutadiene. It has alternate single and double bond. So we can call it as aniline, and this number represents the carbon atoms. We have four carbon atoms, so it is four aniline. Benzene is six aniline. Cyclooctatetraene is 8 aniline. This one is 10 aniline. So they contain only a single cycle but consist of alternate single and double bonds. This is the smallest aniline. In higher anilines, means anilines containing large number of carbon atoms or with big ring size, maintaining its planarity is a hurdle due to steric clashes between internal hydrogen atoms. So in many cases we can see the loss of planarity due to internal steric clashes. In the case of 4 and pi electron system, we have studied that they can act as anti-aromatic compounds. But in large ring systems, even if they have 4 and pi electrons, they cannot exist as anti-aromatic, because in large ring system, conformational flipping is very easy and their planarity will be lost. When planarity is lost, system will no longer be anti-aromatic, but it changes to non-aromatic. In the last session itself, we have studied about some anilines, 4 aniline, that is non-aromatic, sorry, anti-aromatic. This one is aromatic. This is non-aromatic due to the lack of planarity. It changes to a tub shape. Then, now we have 10 aniline. After 8 aniline, we have 10 aniline. It is non-aromatic. Why? In 10 aniline, you can see 5 pi bonds. 5 pi bonds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have 10 pi electrons. 2 pi, 6 pi, 10 pi, 14 pi, etc. are aromatic compounds. But even if we have 10 pi electrons, this compound is non-aromatic, because you can see two internal hydrogen in first carbon and sixth carbon. First carbon and sixth carbon, you can see internal hydrogens, this one and this one. Due to internal clash or steric hindrance between these two hydrogen atoms, this molecule will lose its planarity and changes to this shape. Due to the lack of planarity, they are considered to be non-aromatic, even if they have 10 pi electrons. But when we add a bridge between first carbon and sixth carbon by removing
these two hydrogens. When we have to introduce a bridge, definitely you have to replace that hydrogens. By substituting that hydrogen by a CH2 group or CH2 bridge, planarity can be maintained. Under such condition, this molecule is aromatic. Otherwise, we can make a direct link between 1 and 6, direct link between these two carbon, then you will get naphthalene, that is also aromatic. So, ternary is not aromatic, but bridged one is aromatic. When we come to 12 aniline, we have 12 carbon and 12 pi electrons, alternate single and double bond. Compound is anti-aromatic. Since they can maintain the planarity, they are anti-aromatic. Since they are anti-aromatic, it is not stable above minus 50 degrees Celsius, but it's dianion. This structure totally 14 pi electrons, 12 pi plus this anion also, it is aromatic, so it is stable at 30 degrees Celsius or room temperature. Now we come to 14 aniline. In case of aniline, you have to put a bracket.
14 aniline, 14 is a number belongs to aromaticity. So normally it is an aromatic compound. Since it has alternate single and double bond, 14 pi electrons, delocalization is possible and planarity is maintained. But it has two equilibrium structures, 1 and 2. These are two structures. ZE nomenclature, I think you know it very well, so I am not wish to explain it in detail. This compound itself is aromatic and aromaticity can be improved by removing two hydrogens from adjacent carbon and introducing an additional pi bond. Instead of double bond, you can see a triple bond here. But in delocalization only one pi bond is involved. So it is aromatic. Otherwise, aromaticity can be improved by introducing a lock system between internal carbons 13, 3, 6 and 10. 16 aniline. In 16 aniline, carbon-carbon single bond is 1.46 angstrom and carbon-carbon double bond is 1.34 angstrom. Definitely, we can see that there is a lack of effective delocalization. If there was effective delocalization, the bond length should be same for all carbon and carbon. This delocalization is restricted due to the non-planarity, so it is non-aromatic. But it's dianion, that is aromatic. When we come to 18 aniline, this is a large ring system. So even if we have 6 internal hydrogens, this cavity is large enough to accommodate them. So there is no sufficient internal clashes between these two hydrogens. So this compound is considered to be aromatic in spite of the presence of this much of hydrogen in the internal cavity. When we introduce a saturated system at the center, this aromaticity can be improved.
This is the aromaticity of anilines. We have discussed 10, 12, 14, 16 and 18 anilines. And this topic is expected to be important for exams. Thank you.